You guys talked about it takes them 9 months to do a 3-minute cartoon. I know we're trying to do a lot. We're trying to make a minute and a half cartoon in like 7 weeks, 3-hour sessions or something. But we can do it. It's gonna be fun and kind of bouncy and weird. But we can do it. But we really got to start filming now.
I'm John Seroff. I'm the Director of Marketing and Public Relations for Young Audiences New York. The Animation Project is a collaboration with the Sony Wonder Technology Lab, where we take young students who interact with us to try and create stop motion animation.
My name is Tom Hart. I'm a cartoonist and an animator. Most of my background is in comic books, graphic novels, comic strips also. I did a lot of flash animation. I've been teaching at the School of Visual Arts for 10 years. I've been teaching in the cartooning department. We love to reach out to kids who haven't done it in the past and don't have an arts program in their school.
What we really look for is self-motivation, students who are willing to go the extra mile and take the time out of classes. They're not being graded. They're not doing this for any other reason except, you know, they want the experience to find out what making this sort of a piece is like.
I'm Ashley Infante, and I come from Bronx Leadership Academy too. I heard about Yanni from my art teacher, who is like really enthusiastic about my artwork, and she was like, "Oh, you have to join! Oh my God, it's perfect for you." She knows I like animating, so I joined.
My name is Rafael Santos, and I go to John Dewey High School. I heard of Yanni from my art teacher. I thought it would be a real interesting program to do. I was drawn to join this program from seeing that there was other kids like myself that are interested in doing what I like to do, stop motion.
Young Audiences really strives to try and make art more part of the students' curriculum, to put art back in the classroom where we really strongly believe it belongs.
The sad thing about arts leaving, you know, I hope that's not completely leaving schools, but the sad thing about it being a little less vibrant in the public schools right now is that it's a real asset, and this creative process is so valuable, and that's one service we're providing, is we're giving them an insight into the creative process, which is something as an adult you use every single day.
I'm interested in animation and artwork, and I do want to do something big with that, maybe a career doing it. So I thought maybe Yanni would give me more experiences and more opportunities.
I've learned techniques of how to animate, like different stuff that I hadn't known before about stop motion animation.
What's more important to us is that students not only get an exposure to the arts, but a deep connection with the arts, an ability to take part in the experience, to learn more deeply.
My favorite part would be having to collaborate in order to bring something that we work together to life.
My favorite part is bringing my creations to life, because it's so cool just to watch what you've made from your mind just move around and walk around and stuff. I think that's cool.
Along the process of taking this class, Tom gave me a lot of ideas and techniques to bring my animation to the next level.
Tom is really cool, and he's fun to work with, and he has given me a lot of ideas and stuff, and I learned a lot from him, such as a lot of animating strategies I'm probably gonna use if I become famous.
If you can really look at a piece of art and find something beautiful and meaningful inside of it, then what you're doing is finding something beautiful and meaningful inside of the person who made that art. I think that eases connection between people, between cultures, races, ethnicities, and allows us to really express the very best of what makes us human.
I think they've learned deeper things that they don't realize, and especially I think their skill at telling a story gets a little better. But you know what else? It's the ability to work creatively in groups, to find a consensus and to dole out responsibility and to figure out how this story that they all conceive of 5 weeks prior or 7 weeks prior, how they're gonna make that story happen once they've agreed that that was the story they wanted to tell.
The film we are making is about a boy who doesn't want to eat his vegetables, and his mother is just like, "Oh my God, eat your vegetables." And the boy's like, "No," and then they get into like a huge fight, and the moral of the story is respect your mom, because the mom won and he has to eat his vegetables.
The film I'm making, I think it's gonna be very interesting once it debuts, because all the things I like to do, it's something unexpected. It's definitely gonna make you like raise your eyebrows. So it's like, whoa, what is this? I never thought of this, because like, I'm full of crazy ideas, and I want to express that through the film I'm doing.